Hey guys, it's Sir Peach Ranger, and today we're going to be reacting to the full story of Five Nights at Wario's. I've been wanting to react to it, and since I've uploaded nothing on my channel, so let's get into it. Wario! It is the jump scares. And that's it. Thus, I created Five Nights at Wario's. If you have played the games, the story will be easy to follow. But to everyone, I advise to pay attention, as it can get confusing. This is the full story of Five Nights at Wario's.
Rosalina, queen of the cosmos, always watching over the universe. The universe where the Martian kingdom is located. But this is not the only universe in existence. Universes exist in an infinite amount, all coexisting in perfect balance. Thus the Martian kingdom exists in many variations, similar yet different in parallel universes.
So you're putting multiverse theory into this now. Or parallel universe theory. No, they fucked it up ever since.
In this reality, Wario and Waluigi have recently opened up their own cafe. Known simply as Wario. They had a small budget, so the cafe was pretty small. Everything was going the right way.
I thought Wario's rich. He owns a bloody moon. Spooky.
A couple of years passed, and they eventually decided to close up Wario's cafe, and instead use all of the money to build Wario's dream, a massive ice cream empire. They built it in a very old area, where the remains of some really old buildings still can see. The deck room was built on top of the
buildings.
However, they quickly figured out there was too much work above them, running a big factory by themselves. So they hired Mario and Luigi, and even the princess came by now and then to check on how things were going, before she eventually started working herself from time to time.
The princess? Why?
Still, Mario realized that they slowly went corrupt. The factory didn't get them nearly as much income as he had thought. Then one evening, he was about to close up the factory for the day. He saw something old sticking out the duct just outside the front door. It was a book. An ancient book. 14th century. It was a witch's book. A demonic ritual book. Turns out the factory had been built on top of the remains of the cabins of an ancient witch coven. Wario willing to do anything for money at that point.
Witchcraft exists in the Martian Kingdom, apparently.
Also, in the end, the factory got cursed. He sold his and his co-workers' souls to demonic forces. In change for it, the effect was their souls were doomed. Become cursed with grief, anger, and confusion. Only after death eventually comes. Wario not telling anyone else about his actions. Instead, told the others that they had gotten a great income on their plastic production.
Wario, wow.
The others were terribly joined. Until one day, someone broke into the factory and hoped to steal the secret hammer recipe. His name was Bruno Gates. Hiding in the basement, he panicked as he heard footsteps
They're talking about superpower humans. How can they lose to mere humans? Okay.
Selena of this reality saw this and understood the danger and what had happened and what could happen. She knew that due to the curse, that they would not stop fighting, even not even if they managed to kill the monster. She only saw one solution. She created a portal that bended space-time. The portal sucked out the cursed souls of the five bodies. And by sending them through the portal, she sent the souls back in time, in hope that this would undo what had been done. She tried to send their souls back in time, to a time before the curse was ended, before Wario went to the ritual. What Rosalina did not know, however, was that it created a paradox. She did not know that the demonic curse transcended time and space. The souls had been sent back in time, with the curse still attached to them. This meant that the past had now been changed. A change in history had just been made.
I find it odd that Mario would just be like, "Oh, you stabbed me. I'm going to let that stay there for a bit. I'm going to die now." Did it again.
Died in the pile.
How?
Bowser's body was found and
later buried under the ruins of WarioWare Incorporated. What the police did not...
Bowser died. He has a why does it not harden his shell? You can call the CrossFit crab. Crabs is jealous.
To celebrate, Wario got himself a Wario Man costume, which he used in different settings for a mascot. Then, one day, the thief, Bruno Gates, who also did the same thing in the first timeline, entered the factory early in the morning, waiting in the cellar. He was after the secret recipe.
Oh my god, it's just like... SpongeBob.
Before saying to himself, I can use this. Wario was alone in the factory for a while this day, sitting in the office, when he saw his Wario Man costume moving through the cameras. The thief, disguised in the Wario Man costume, was trying to sneak up on Wario to threaten him to kill the recipe. When Waluigi appeared later the same day, the thief took his chance. Wario, as he was dying, fell down the staircase and knocked out two of his teeth in the process. The thief remained in the back, looking for the secret recipe. Still shocked at
that's what he just done.
It was the same day that Mario, Luigi, and eventually Princess Peach entered the factory, since Wario and Luigi didn't come home at the work. In panic, Bruno Gates hung Luigi by the neck, stabbed Princess Peach.
Makes no sense. That annoys me actually. Music's good.
7 years passed before a company decided to reopen Wario's castle. The factory was now old and unstable, so they needed a security guard during the first night. This job went to the new employee, Richard. During the first week, he got a phone call from another employee
don't know why I'm doing this, but...
It was during these nights that the possessed bodies of Wario and the rest started to attack him for the first time in 7 years. Richard McGoy managed to survive the superficial attack, which left him a bit traumatized. By the end of the week, the employee who had been calling Richard during the nights decided to come over and check on things, only to be murdered by Wario. Richard McRoy quits his job the day after, and the factory closes for good, never to be opened again. The same company is planning to open another of Wario's old businesses. In the meantime, Richard McRoy experienced more and more weird things, and he kept on having more and more nightmares. He had nightmares of him watching a TV screen he could not move away from, and the demonic apparitions from the fast food factory would appear in the different TV channels, trying to leap out into his face before he would wake up and sweat. This is the era of Five Nights at Wario's. This was the cause of the cursed spirit of Luigi, who had left his own body to slowly try and possess Richard McRoy over the coming months, leading up to the
Luigi. He just used sprite animation for that.
Their soulless, dead, zombie-like bodies would be used to turn the Wario into a soldier. He also seeked out more victims to add to his demonic arm.
Oh, demonic arm. Yoshi. It just seems ludicrous that you go that far to do it.
Richard McRoy would call him each night to give him instructions, but he would also clearly become more and more possessed by the evil Luigi with each night.
Now that's actually kind of spooky.
Escaped Wario when he incorporated, now hiding in the shadows.
Oh, that That's hot.
Survive the days by hiding in different rooms. It was at this point that the soul of the original killer in the fast food factory, Bruno Gates, fully knew what he had done. He felt that he had to apologize to the others in order for him to bring peace to himself. He managed to find out which street Wario and the rest were on, but he couldn't exactly locate which house. He kept looking, but he never found them. At the end of the week, Richard McCroy came out of the house himself and killed Edward Coleman, the new employee, down in the cellar. On his way there, he also killed Max Peterson. Peach now left Richard McCroy's body and returned to her own. Mario, Luigi, Waluigi, and Peach now continued on their way. It was at this point Rosalina saw that this had to be stopped. She found them, and similar to the very first timeline, she created a portal in space time, sucked out the cursed soul of the five, and sent them back in time to Mario and Waluigi's first cafe. Thus, the story repeats itself. A cycle has been created. The whole story of Pilots and Wario is a cycle. It was one timeline that due to the ancient witch curse and Rosalina sending them back in time, history had changed. And in this new timeline, Rosalina doesn't remember what happened in the first timeline since time has now started over. Therefore, of Rosalina stepping in and sending them back.
That's not how time works.
This restarts the cycle.
The time doesn't work like that, I tell you that. That's actually interesting.
There's only one way to break the endless loop. And that is to lift the curse. Otherwise, Rosalina will keep sending them back in time. The only one who is able to lift the curse is Edward Coleman, the new employee in the security company. Inside Richard Maxwell's house, there were pieces of a music box that Richard owned when he was a kid. Edward Coleman managed to assemble all parts. When he was done in the cellar, he played the music box. The original killer, Bruno Gates, who wandered in the Wario Man costume in the streets outside, heard this music box. He immediately went inside the house and down in the cellar. And it was there that Wario and the crew met the killer again after so long. Bruno Gates, now knowing what he had really done, apologized to the killer, asking for forgiveness. Forgiveness was the only thing to defeat grief. It was the key to defeat the curse.
Forgive me. No. Oh, I broke that.
Ever
No worries. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next reaction, maybe. And make sure you subscribe to my channel and like it.